Are you looking to enhance your BuddyBoss app with a sleek and functional directory for other post types, such as courses, events, or perhaps your recipes? The directory block makes it easier than ever to showcase different post types in a structured and user-friendly layout. In this tutorial, we'll walk you through the process of adding, configuring, and customizing the directory block to fit your needs. Whether you're displaying posts, forum discussions, or custom post types from supported plugins, we've got you covered. Let's get started. To begin, navigate to BuddyBoss App, App Pages, then click Add New App Page. I'll name this page Directory Block. Now, let's add the directory block. Keep in mind that this block works independently and cannot be combined with other blocks. If you try adding a directory block to a page that already contains other blocks, an error message will appear. Likewise, adding any additional block to a page that contains a directory block will trigger the same error. Next, open the app block settings and locate the Select Post Type dropdown. Here, you can choose the type of content you want to display. By default, you can select posts, pages, forum discussions, if the component is enabled. Additionally, you can display custom post types from supported third-party plugins. For example, on this site, we have the Learn Dash and Event Calendar plugin activated. So on the dropdown, we can choose to display Learn Dash courses, lessons, or scheduled events from the events calendar and add up to 4 meta. For a full list of supported plugins, check out the written documentation linked in the description. For this tutorial, I will select events from the dropdown. You can toggle this option to display or hide the featured image for your selected post type. By default, Meta 1 is added. You can enable or disable a meta using this toggle or change the displayed data using this dropdown. Note, for the directory block, you can only add up to 4 meta here. In the future, we'll add more layouts and blocks which can use more fields. Let's add another meta field. Notice how the preview updates in real time, allowing you to see exactly how it will look in the app. Now, I'll add 2 more meta fields. Here's how the directory block looks with all 4 meta fields added. Next, let's set up the directory options. These settings are straightforward. Simply enable or disable the options you want to include. Keep in mind that some options depend on your site's active settings or components. For example, if you selected posts here and the bookmarking setting is disabled, the show bookmark option won't be available. For this tutorial, I'll enable everything. Next, choose how the post will be displayed using the order by and order settings. You can order the post by, post ID, author name, title, and more, random, or you can use the meta you added earlier. Then, choose whether the order should be ascending or descending. Once everything is set up, click Publish. Now, let's add this page to our app menu. Navigate to BuddyBoss App, Menu, Tab, Bar. To make space, I'll remove an existing menu item. Locate the App Pages section, then add the Directory Block page. Let's quickly change its icon as well. Then click Save Menu. Now, let's switch to the app and see how it looks. Don't forget to hard quit your app for all changes to take effect. I'm now in our app, and here's the directory block we just added. As you can see, it displays the selected post type along with the featured images, meta details, and directory options we configured earlier. The layout is clean and easy to navigate, making it simple for users to browse through the listed content. Try experimenting with different meta fields, sorting options, and display settings to match your app's needs. And that's how you can set up and customize the directory block in your BuddyBoss app. If you found this tutorial helpful, don't forget to give this video a like and subscribe for more BuddyBoss tips and guides. Let us know in the comments how you're using the directory block in your app. We'd love to hear your ideas. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next tutorial.